Hey guys, little reminder, G Fuel Code Madness Round 1 is still going on, so right now, code IMMORTAL will get you 30% off your entire order. And the more code uses we get, the better chance we have of getting our very own IMMORTAL Shaker Cup. Anyways, on to today's video. Ladies and gentlemen, hey hi, how you doing? Welcome back to the channel. Of course, it is Tuesday, and that means Modern Warfare has received another brand new update. Last week, we got the 1.15 patch kind of out of the blue, and that brought with it a few new features, and while today's update is by no means a huge surprise, it does include a handful of new content to look into. So today we're breaking down all the changes that just came to the game with the newest mini update. Little side note though, if you are new here, or if you happen to be a part of the 70% of viewers who are not subscribed, I am always covering the latest Call of Duty news, intel, and other information. So feel free to subscribe if you want to stay on top of that stuff. And of course, if you enjoy the video at any point, let me know by dropping a like on it. Now, prior to today's update going live, there was actually a completely hidden hotfix update that went live over the weekend that Infinity Ward mentioned, just not in the most public of ways. Usually, we do get our Friday blog posts that preview what we can expect to see in the following week as far as new modes and content goes. But this week, Infinity Ward never tweeted out or really mentioned anything about said blog post. However, lo and behold, there was actually a blog post that went up, and I guess they just forgot to mention it, truly I'm not too sure. Regardless though, some changes that you'll now notice that were just never mentioned include a fix to the rank reset prompt on the main menu, fixes for regiment invites, a fix for the quick fix perk not functioning with specialist, and also a fix for killstreaks not being banned in the CDL playlist. So there's those in case you're interested. But getting into what today's update has in store for the game, honestly, being that it is a mini update, up front we don't really have anything too crazy. Now, the first major change you'll notice is that weekly playlist update that has basically become a standard at this point, and this week we've actually got quite a few fan favorites back in the playlist lineup. The main standout this week is definitely the return of Shoot the Ship, which of course is a combination of Shoot House 24/7 and Shipment 24/7, which certainly seem to be the most popular maps so far this year. Now, Rust was previously included in the rotation alongside Shoot House and Shipments as a part of the Dirty Old Boathouse playlist, but it's honestly kinda weird. Rust, I feel like, has a very strange reception in this game, right? Some people absolutely love it, others absolutely despise it. I myself am kind of indifferent. I will say the spawns are completely whack on Rust. It's not my favorite map, but it's also not the worst map either. Anyways, the 24/7 playlist has been cut down to feature just Shoot House and Shipments, with the usual modes in play for that one. Now, we also have some adjustments to some other playlists that we have seen before, including Gunfight Trios or 3v3, and also the 1v1 Me Bro or 1-on-1 playlist as well. So, as far as the normal playlists go for this week, we do have Quick Play per usual, which also features the CDL Rotations tab, so there's that if you want to get a little extra competitive. Then we've also got the Gunfight Tournament, which still has no official end date, the Boots on the Ground War playlist with no tanks, and they also just removed the realism feature as well, so now it is basically just normal Ground War, minus the tanks and also minus the helicopters. We also have regular Ground War, regular Gunfight, Gunfight 3v3, 1v1 Me Bro, which now has the radar turned on, and also voice chat that relays to your opponents, and of course, Shoot the Ship as we already talked about. So honestly, quite a bit of variety for this week. I do think it is kind of interesting they removed Giant Infection already, but hey, this is not a bad selection by any means. Then, getting into the store update for this week, of course, right alongside the playlist refresh, we also see some new bundles added into the store for people to buy if they so choose, and this week we do have a few new content drops to check out. So the first bundle we've got is going to be the Tamagotchi bundle, and that's going to be available for 1,000 COD points. And this features the Tamagotchi Watch as the main attraction, I guess, and that actually reacts to how you're performing in-game. And this has been a pretty heavily anticipated feature, so it's pretty cool that it's now here. And this bundle also features a calling card, an emblem, a charm, a sticker, and also a spray. Then we've got the Retro Gamer bundle for 1,400 COD points, which features the Glitch Trigger blueprint, the Button Masher blueprint, a charm, and also an emblem. Then we have a third new bundle for this week too, and this is the Action Express bundle, which is available for 1,200 COD points, and this features the Freight Train blueprint, a calling card, and also an emblem. However, this Uzi variant does feature the brand new ammo upgrade that we saw added in last week, So if you want to just outright buy it instead of doing the challenge, you do have the option to do so. Now, we've also got some back-end changes that were made today too, including a speed increase to the sprint out time on the Uzi, and an increase to the close and medium range damage for the 5.45 rounds on the AK-47, which was originally supposed to be buffed last week. However, they messed up, so it's officially confirmed it is changed as of today. Also, on the factory barrel for the SA-87, the recoil is now properly reduced as stated originally in the 1.15 patch notes. Now, in some less exciting news, obviously a lot of players were anticipating some kind of classified or Warzone news to come today, since we had a ton of things in-game pointing towards the date of 3-3 or March 3rd, so today. But alas, it seems nothing really changed. The classified tab section is still all fuzzy. Some players were saying it was maybe a bit more distorted. Honestly, I'm not too sure, but either way, no Warzone news was brought to light. So, the waiting game continues. Now, as always on update day, I do like to go ahead and check out the Trello board, which is home to all the current progress reports on bug fixes, changes, and content plans alike. And this really gives us a solid idea of what exactly Infinity Ward is looking into for future updates. So, in multiplayer, we've got a few things IW has listed as an in-progress situation, meaning they are working on fixing it or adjusting whatever it is to their liking. And these in-progress updates include player collision, which has already been quote-unquote fixed once. However, it is still pretty rough from time to time, so they're not quite done with that one, it seems. Then we've also got slide canceling, the tack insert spots on Rust, the frame rate issues on Rust, the new icon appearing when there's nothing new to be seen, regiment player counts causing errors, and finally, the regain 1000 health with stim challenge not tracking as intended. So, some repeats, some new ones, but hopefully we'll have some fixes to these and all the other issues and bugs we've covered in recent weeks out pretty soon. I know some of these topics have been on the board for multiple weeks at this point, some have been on there for well over a month, which, I won't lie, is a bit concerning to see, but hey, at least we know they are being looked into. Then, over on PC, it's basically all the same stuff that we covered last week. However, they are also working on fixing these shaders installing issues that became more apparent after the 1.15 title update. Then in Spec Ops, we don't really have any new groundbreaking discoveries or worthwhile notes here, and same deal goes for single player as well. So really, the Trello board does not provide us with a ton of information this week, outside of some soon-to-be-fixed problems over in multiplayer. Now, on top of the Trello board, we do also have one other direct source of information for future content, and that of course is the Season 2 roadmap. Now, so far we have seen all of the Day 1 content added in, obviously, and as far as the in-season updates go, we've also seen the Bizarre Gunfight map, the Mace Operator, the NVG Reinforce mode, and also the Gunfight tournaments all added in. Now, you might be saying, but Zach, didn't we also see Infected Ground War added in too since we've got Giant Infection? And, well, here's my thinking. Keep in mind, this is just simply speculation, but I think Giant Infection and Infected Ground War are actually two completely different things. For one, Giant Infection is only 48 players, and also it only takes place on Anaya Palace. Ground War is notorious for featuring 64 players, except for on Anaya Palace. And obviously we've got Karst River Quarry, Boneyard, Port, Provnik Farmland, and also Tavorsk in the rotation for that as well. And Ground War Infected is not Ground War Infected without all of those maps. So honestly, I think Giant Infection is just a new mode to keep us busy until the real 64-player Infected mode debuts on the other Ground War maps. But I digress. On the roadmap, we also see we have the Talon Operator coming to the game in the next few weeks, as well as a brand new DLC weapon that many players are saying is going to be a brand new shotgun similar to the M26. However, for those we don't have any official release dates confirmed, but if and when we do, I'll be sure to keep you guys updated. Anyways, with all of that being said, that is effectively everything that changed with the new mini update here in Modern Warfare, and that is going to wrap things up for today. If you guys enjoyed the video, let me know by dropping a like on it. And of course, if you're new here, and you want to stay up to date with the latest Call of Duty news and intel, updates and leaks, and pretty much everything else in between, feel free to subscribe with your notifications turned on, that way you'll always know when I post a new video. As I mentioned earlier, G Fuel Code Madness is now live, and we've got a chance to get our very own Immortal Shaker Cup. So if you do want to help me out and get me one step closer to it, be sure to use code IMMORTAL and get yourself 30% off your order on gfuel.com. Once again, thanks so much for tuning in, and until next time, take it easy, have an awesome rest of your day, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace out.